Last time, we were talking about some of the most beautiful basketball court in the world. So this time, we are talking about the terminologies in basketball. But it is only some selected and most important terminologies in playing basketball. Number one is the air ball. Air ball is a shot that misses the rim or backboard. The next one is the alive. Alive is an offensive player who has the ball and has not dribbled. So I want you to try to check all the videos that I am playing so that you are familiar with these following terminologies in basketball. The next one is the alternating possession rule. This is the first possession after a held ball goes to the team who lost the opening jump ball to begin the game. And assist, it is a pass to a teammate that results in a made basket. The next one is the backdoor. Backdoor is an offensive move where a player cuts behind the defenders and receives a pass for a field goal attempt. Ball handler, of course, that is the player with the ball, and it is usually the guard at the start of the play. Then we have the bank shot. The bank shot is a shot where the ball is first bounce or bank off the backboard at such an angle that it then drops into the basket. So as I said last time, backboard can help you to produce a point when you play basketball. The blind pass, it is a pass from a ball handler who does not see the receiver but is estimating where they should be. So if you have seen in the video, you are not sure where the handler passed the ball to any receiver or teammate. The next one is the block shot. It is the successful deflection of a shot by touching part of the ball on its way to the basket and preventing a failed goal. And then the blocking. The blocking is the use of a defender's body position to legally prevent an opponent's advance. So remember, this is also an opposite of what you call charging. And the next one is the charging. It is an offensive foul which occurs when an offensive player runs into a defender who has established position. And then the court vision, you need to be or to have an ability to see everything on the court during play. Then, when you say crossover dribble, I think some of you are familiar with that. When a player handler dribbles the ball across their body from one hand to the other, that is what you call the cross dribble. And then the cut, it is a quick movement by an offensive player without the ball to gain an advantage over the defense, usually directed towards the basket. How about the dead? The dead is an offensive player, has the ball, and has already used their dribble. They must now either pass or shot the ball. Okay, the next one is the dead ball. Any player with a ball that is not live and this occurs after its successful field goal, free throw attempt, after any official's whistle, or if the ball leaves the court, then play is stopped. How about the defense? It is the act of preventing the offense from scoring. It is the team without the ball. And then the down court, the direction of a team on offense move from its back court to its front court and towards its own basket. And how about the double dribble? That is the act of dribbling the ball, stopping the dribble or motion of the ball and beginning to dribble again. So the result, of course, violation and turnover. About dribble, we have many types of dribbling. So that is the act of bouncing the ball up and down. The offensive player with the ball uses the dribble to move the ball around the court. And lastly, of course, the drive. That is the movement of an offensive player while aggressively dribbling towards the basket and an attempt to score. And the last one, the dunk. a shot in which a jumping player slams from the ball into the opponent's basket from above. And of course, exhibition game, the ako playing another team and the outcome not being counted in any league standing. Okay, so exhibition game, some of the purpose of this is only to evaluate the team, and also some, they use it as a fundraising game. I hope you need to familiarize some of the terminologies and other terminologies in basketball. I hope you enjoy what you have seen and learn about the terminologies in basketball.